Access for Everyone, breaking down digital barriers for people with disabilities. Topic 6, the importance of manual testing for digital accessibility.
Let's turn to the big, broad topic, manual testing. Manual testing is just what it sounds like. You're manually checking a web page without relying on an automated checker to see how accessible it is for people with disabilities.
Automated checkers are software or apps that you can access online or through a vendor. Some are free. They scan web pages and check for specific barriers, like whether a form field has a label or if alternative text is available for your images. However, the automated checker is unable to determine whether the label or alternative text is meaningful. It only checks to ensure there's something there. These checkers are somewhat helpful, but they're automated, and they can't tell you about actual user experiences. For example, whether a keyboard user or a screen reader user will be able to interact successfully with the page. And since automated checkers can only scan for certain things, even the best of them miss a lot of serious barriers, and they will flag some things as problems that aren't problems at all. So, we'll show you some easy-to-use tools and techniques on how to manually check a web page using keyboard access, magnification and reflow, alternative text, captions, color contrast, and logical reading order. This is an overview video of several topics, so to learn more, check out our videos on each of these topics.
First, I'll need to check for keyboard access and a good visual focus indicator. I want to start by seeing what elements are normally available for someone who can use a mouse. So I hover over the web page, over the menu, the drop-down menus, and various links on this fictitious sample university demo page we've created. Then I refresh the page, and I try to get to the same elements with the tab key and other keyboard commands. Another thing I want to do is enlarge the web page to 200% to see how the page works for people who magnify the page because they have low vision. We want to check pages at reflow, which is when the page changes to mobile-friendly format, and see how responsive it is.
As we mentioned earlier, an automated checker can determine whether an image has alternative text, but only a human being can really decide whether the alternative text or label is meaningful. Here, when I reveal the alternative text for the menu button, sometimes called a hamburger because of the way the lines stack up, we will see it is identified as mobile links. But the words mobile links don't tell a blind user what those links are for.
Another thing that needs manual testing is whether the video captions effectively communicate the video's audio for people who are deaf or hard of hearing. Automated checkers are not able to tell whether captions are effectively communicating the audio content or whether they are properly synced with the video. With the popularity and ease of automated captioning growing, it's essential to make sure the captioning makes sense so everyone has equal access to information conveyed in the video.
You're also going to need to consider how color is used. Color is an important asset in design, enhancing a web page's appeal and usability. But some users are blind or have difficulty perceiving color, and automated checkers are unable to determine whether important information on a site is conveyed using color alone, or whether there is enough contrast between the foreground and background color of the text. And how about the page's layout? You'll want to make sure that people, including those who use assistive technology such as screen readers, are able to read the page's content in the order you want them to read it in.
So remember, automated checkers are okay, but you will still need to do manual testing to make sure you really know what is going on. That includes assessing the functionality of the page when it's magnified, checking for meaningful alternative text and labels, meaningful video captions, sufficient color contrast, logical reading order, and other things. There are no shortcuts, and there is no product you can buy that will thoroughly and accurately check your web page for accessibility. And when you do the manual testing, you'll have the satisfaction of knowing you're on your way to ensuring full and equal access for everyone, including those with disabilities.
This video was produced by the U.S. Department of Education Office for Civil Rights.
You can find us at ed.gov/OCR or email us at OCR@ed.gov.